Let's talk about the first sign of a vitamin F deficiency. Now, you're probably going, what is vitamin F, right? Well, in past times, there was a vitamin F, but now we don't call it vitamin F because it doesn't really fit the traditional definition of a true vitamin, which is kind of an isolated compound coming from nature. But vitamin F really is the combination of two essential fatty acids. The definition of essential in this context means that it must come from your diet. Your body can't make it. Okay. The same thing with essential amino acids. Those are amino acids that must be gotten from the diet because your body can't make them, versus a non-essential amino acid which your body can make. Okay, so these essential fatty acids are two. One is an omega-3 fatty acid, and the other is an omega-6 fatty acid. The omega-3 is ALA, alpha-linoleic acid, and the omega-6, which is LA, linoleic acid. Now, these are two essential fats that you need in every single organ of your body. They help you absorb calcium. They're both very important components in cell structure, in cell flexibility, and in cell growth. Now, the big problem with these essential fatty acids is in the ratio that we consume them. In the Western diet, we consume 10 to 20 times more omega-6 fatty acids than we do omega-3. The ideal ratio would be like 2-to-1 or even 1-to-1, not 20-to-1, okay? When this ratio becomes so far out of balance, you're gonna start developing all sorts of problems with your cells. And the first sign or symptom would be dry and flaky skin. So if you have dry and flaky skin, just realize you're doing too many omega-6 fatty acids to your omega-3 fatty acids. So you want to cut those down and start consuming more like cod liver oil or fish oil and not the other oils like corn oil, soy oil, which are hidden in a lot of different foods. And I'm going to put a link down below for more information on that. There's other problems as well, like prostate enlargement, inflammation, problems with your vision, problems with the heart, problems with your brain, like memory problems. So the key is to really get these ratios. If you want to get these ratios, you can start consuming certain foods. I'm going to list them right here. Avocados have a really good ratio of these fats. Any leafy greens have the right ratios. Almonds, walnuts have the right amounts. Sprouts of any seeds have good ratios. Chia seed, sunflower seed, olive oil, make sure it's the real thing. Fish, especially fatty fish, have the best ratios. And eggs. So we really get in trouble when we start doing like fried foods, junk foods, fast food, and start using the salad dressing with all the soy oil. And there's literally thousands of foods at the grocery store with corn oil and canola oil and cottonseed oil in many different forms that you need to start avoiding. So start to evaluate your foods from the standpoint of these two essential fatty acids to make sure you're getting the right ratios. Ideally, they should be 1-to-1. Hey, before you go, if you're benefiting from any of my content, I would love to hear about your success story. Please share it in the link down below.